Thank
Now
you, ma'am.
I can see on the screen Dr. P.C. Markanda ji.
Yeah, I'm available.
Yeah, I would like to get you introduced with the Honorable Most Respected Secretary of PCM SG College for Women, Jalandhar. I would like to make a mention of the fact that the college, PCM SG College, PCM is Premchand Markanda ji, and Premchand Markanda ji happens to be respected honorable father of our secretary, Shri Pramod Chand Markanda ji, who is with us right now on the screen. With regard to Dr. P.C. Markanda ji, he is a great intellectual, very devoted, very dedicated, with a very strong determination and very strong willpower. What makes me say like this? I give you an example. About 2 years ago, he came to the college and he was carrying a big bulky books in 3 volumes, which were very heavy for me to carry, weak principal. And you know, I was shocked, surprised to see that I was just wondering, how did he manage to write the book? Because out of 30 days, 26 days, he's out of station. He belongs to Chandigarh otherwise. Most of the time, if I say 26, that means 26 days he's out of station. And he is a very learned person, expertise in arbitration particularly. When I asked him, I said, Markanda sahab, how did you manage writing these bulky books? He said, from morning 4 o'clock to 9 o'clock, I was always there on my table writing about the book. I said, but then most of the time you are out of the station, sometimes coming back to Chandigarh at 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock night, sometimes 2 o'clock also. And then how did you manage? He said, Kiran, 4 means 4. Irrespective of the fact whether I sleep 2 o'clock or 10 o'clock, that is not important. 4 o'clock, if I have decided to get up at 4 o'clock and to be on my study table at 4 o'clock, 4 to 9, 4 to 9 means 4 to 9. So I think all good and positive results come when we have such a kind of determination, such a kind of strong willpower. Yesterday, Dr. Kapil Kapoor was with us. He happens to be the chairman of Indian Institute of Advanced Studies, Shimla. He made a mention of his age. He said, I am above 80. And if I talk to you, and if my thoughts are broken, then you don't mind, bear with me, because I am above 80. But with regard to Honorable Secretary of my governing body, he's nearing the age. But I have always seen him well aware, very attentive. And I have never noticed, as on today, any broken thought, always alert. His mind is always active, always alert. And he always, you know, he lives with innovative ideas. Whatever he has been doing in the court, it is only on account of his great intellect. He is a great reader, learned person. And he happens to be visiting professor of a good number of law universities. He has been blessed with 2 sons. Both are advocate, and their wives, I mean his daughters-in-law, they too are advocate. So it's a family of advocate. I salute you, sir, and I welcome you here on the eve of the international conference organized under the dynamic leadership of yours. Welcome, sir. I, on behalf of the faculty members and students of PCMSG College and the delegates, those who are on the screen right now, on behalf of all, I accord you very warm welcome, Dr. Markanda ji. Very warm welcome. I salute you. I bow my head before you. Before your wisdom, I know.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm really very, very happy to be amongst the elite of elite from the field of education. I match you.
You are.
No.
Perfect match. More than that.
You have said too much about me. I'm a student of law.
You deserve more than that.
I'm trying to learn. When you were talking about the age of 80, I was a little shocked. Say goodbye to education. In fact, it starts from 60. When we retire people at the age of 60, that is the age when you have learned so much that you can give it to the society. Now, at the age of 80, I don't know how the young man said that the chain of thoughts may be disturbed. I'm 83. And I don't feel any fatigue, but the field of education to which you people belong to, I'm a total novice. I know nothing about it. I've been hearing with the apt attention two speakers. I've added something to my knowledge. They are great people. And hats off to Dr. Kiran, who has initiated the move to bring together from everybody from the world on this platform for some interaction on Vedic studies. I don't recall in the recent past if there had been any such conference on the topic. I think it should have been something for the common man as well. Next time, Kiran, you initiate something, some conference. My suggestion is, take it or leave it.
Sure, sure.
My suggestion is that it should be a topic which should be of interest to we people. I'm an advocate. I would love to learn something from you. I think it's high time that we engage everybody, not a particular person from a particular field. I can assure you that next time the participation would be so great that it will be difficult for you to manage it. But it is high time that we think of engaging people from various disciplines of education, like law, like commerce, like your education, college education, et cetera, et cetera. It's time that it should not be confined to few people. And you should spread the message of the college to a very large number of people rather than to a limited number of people. I'm happy that the college and the principal in particular and the faculty in particular, they have been so much involved in this conference that I don't think they could devote much time to their families. I'm really excited that the college, which had been named after my father, she's bringing so much of glory to that college. She deserves some pat at the back. And
Thank you so very much. Thank you very much. Dr. Markanda, I can see quite a good number of teachers of our college. They are sending their comments. Good salute to you.
I salute to each one of them.
They are very happy to see you.
So much of pains to make this conference a success.
And thank you so much. I
hope to meet them when I visit the college next time.
Thank you so much.
May God bless.
Thank you so very much. Thank you.